Lee Peanut in Madison County has been one of the real proactive BMP implementers in our area. They started approximately 3 or 4 years ago with some fertilizer trials on their corn, just getting them to reduce the nitrogen that they were using. But since then, they have implemented, all their pivots have soil moisture sensors, and they're also on their corn, they're using wide drops for their fertilizer on their nitrogen, and they've been able to reduce substantially the amount of nitrogen they were putting because they're putting that nitrogen right next to the corn at the right place at the right time.
BMPs, I think, are a good thing because it's really opened my eyes. We used to water, fertilize on opinions because somebody else done it that way, or we saw somebody do this much and it yielded this. Brooks Garland, Lee Peanut Farms in Lee, Florida. We grow peanuts, corn, and sometimes in all season we grow carrots. You know, conserving water and conserving fertilizers, whether that be MP or K, I think is a good thing, and there's a lot of tools that I use to do that on a day-to-day basis. And that has overall reduced my cost of producing a crop, which puts more money in my pocket.
Soil moisture sensors are a piece of technology that we install on the ground that can tell us how deep our root zone is, tell us how deep we just irrigated, how deep the rainfall just went. It can tell us soil moisture, soil temperature, and soil electrical conductivity, which is an indirect measure of salt. So from that, we can kind of get a feeling of where our nutrients are accumulating in the soil. All this information is useful in making irrigation decisions. So if I see a soil moisture sensor where the uppermost layers in that sensor are drying out, I can inform the grower that they might need to irrigate depending on where their roots are. So if it only has shallow roots and the upper portion of the soil profile is drying out, then it's a good time to irrigate.
I love soil moisture probes. It takes all the emotion out of saying, all right, but this person says we need to water then, but the other person says we need to be watering now. So it takes all that emotion out and it puts it to science. It's a clear path of what you need to do as far as managing your water in the soil and your nutrients in the soil. And then the other thing, we have two applicators, especially for corn, that is putting nitrogen right by the row, which is key for placement. And that has helped me save a lot of pounds of N going through the root zone to the aquifer. So I like that too. And also it puts money back in your pocket because you're not buying as much fertilizer overall.
When a producer utilizes a controlled release fertilizer, there is an added advantage to them. Convenience, you know, in terms of only putting it out one time is great, but also knowing that if you get a downpour or an unexpected rainfall event, you don't have to worry, oh wow, is my fertilizer still there? We know that this type of fertilizer is different than a slow release because it is released throughout time based on temperature, and as the temperature increases through the spring, it'll be more efficiently utilized by the plant. We're really proud of some of the producers that we have in the area. For example, Brooks Garland with Lee Peanut, who has adopted this practice already on a 140 acre pivot because it's a 4 hours approach. If you think about just within itself using the controlled release fertilizer, that would be considered an advanced BMP. So you have the 4 R's. If you're using a controlled release fertilizer, it adheres to those principles of nutrient stewardship.
The old school farming was, if a little is good, a lot is better. And today's farmers, they're not in that mindset. The margins are so tight that they don't want to put out extra if they don't get a return on that investment. And they're all using BMPs, or most all of them are using some form of BMP now on farm to help the environment in general. Your groundwater, rivers and streams, just the soil health altogether. And that's what our farmers today, they're more concerned with versus trying to make X amount of bushels per crop or whatever. They're trying to maximize their crop yield, obviously, but they're on the trying to determine what it takes to get there without over exceeding limits of water and nutrients.
I'm putting about 250,000 pounds of N less per year in the dirt just because of those. That's a combination of the soil moisture probes and the knife and rigs, as we call them, but it's with our wild drop rig. I use cover crops for control of erosion, and I also think it helps you on weeds, you know, and pig weeds are a problem in this area, especially for us, because they're atrazine resistant, they're Roundup resistant, so I think that definitely helps.
I think one thing that the general public really needs to understand, that every time a farmer sprays or every time a farmer puts out fertilizer, that's his profit going out of his pocket. And one thing in Florida that is so different than any of the other states that I've been in and visited is most farms in Florida are multi-generation farms. And they plan on their grandkids and their grandkids to keep this farming practices up. So they want to be good stewards of the land because they realize the land is what takes care of them. So by being a good steward, by using the 4R practices, they're doing the best of their ability to help protect and improve the water quality of our state. And they realize how critical water is for our state.